hideous thing! Cinnaberry, hi sweetie! A JoJo DIY, yes! Hi! We'll see how far we can get down with this. I don't know if a lot of you know, I've been suffering with a lot of pain lately. Going through new treatments. Takes time for things to kick in and yada yada yada. Something's going on with my voice. So, let's get some light on this matter, shall we? Donna Johnson, how you doing, sweetie? Living Simple Living. Yes, I love that name. I love that name. I do. Hello, Breaking Shell. It's so good to see you, sweetie. Thank you for stopping by. We're going to be cooking and dancing. We're going to make some oriental cabbage. Well, my version of oriental cabbage that was actually inspired by Hash Info. And I didn't yet get, but I'll put his thingy up there. It's always above the left shoulder, isn't it? Up there somewhere. JoJo DIY, thank you ever so much. I need those prayers right now, I really do. So, let's see what spices we're gonna use first. Definitely ginger. Yes, ginger. Purple marshmallow. Hi, sweetie. My little alien here is growing, but growing slowly. Hopefully, he'll pick up soon. Okay, so my hubby was a bit. Hi, Gomez, sweetie. Linda's house a chill. Yes. So my hubby got a jump start on the chicken over there. So I'm going to transfer it from the big pot to the small pot so it can get a tan in there. Let me stick something here so I can push you over a little bit. I'm going to use a bottle to reposition you a little bit so y'all can see a little better. Because I'm actually going to go digging around in the fridge. I know I have cabbage in there. I hope I have tomatoes in there. Life of a Mill. Hi, sweetie. Hey, it's good to see you. Oriental cabbage. June style. It was actually inspired by Hash Info. And I'll put his iCard up here above my left shoulder when I'm done. The music we're listening to is, of course, my fave, Technetic Beats. Oh, I should say actually one of my faves. I don't play favourites. Well, kind of. No, I don't. Trip over. Come on. coming in the kitchen. Do you think they think I know I'm cooking? Boss Lady Lexi's, good to see you. And Kate James, hi sweetie. I know it's late for you over in the UK. And I'm sorry I'm a little late, I fell asleep. I have a feeling somebody used my tomatoes. Somebody who's height challenged in the house, you don't put something on top of the fridge. Good to see you, honey. Oh, Mary, not Marie. Sorry. Let me put my glasses on. I'll be able to read them. I think. It's not a given. It's not promised. It's not promised that I can read. I love you too, Stella, baby. Hey, Stella. Annie's getting impatient. She wants her chicken. Cabbage. One cabbage head that's been sort of sliced up. Let me give you a hint. Sometimes not helping is helping. Yeah, she can have hers. Okay. I'm gonna use some really light. Am I? Do I? No, get your set. Okay, we're gonna use Lynn Perrins Worcestershire sauce. Say that, Linda. How do you say it? Worcestershire sauce. Not Worcestershire or Worcestershire, it's Worcestershire. Carrie Gomez, hi sweetie. So good to see you. Marie Kaplinger, hi honey. Okay, we're getting there folks. We are getting there. Yes we are. Okay. And I think that's all I need out of my cupboard. So it's kind of an oriental cabbage with my take on it, inspired by Hashinfo. And I'll put his link up the top there at the end, and the music that we're listening to is Technetic Beats, and I'll put the link down below and also in an iCard at the top too. Oh, thank you, Queen's Princess. There's a man in my kitchen. Can you hear the music? I forgot to ask you. There you go, Worcestershire sauce. It's never pronounced how it looks. Okay. Gotta use a little bit of sunflower oil. A little bit. And this is quite easy. It's not fancy. It sounds fancy. Charlene! Hi, sweetie. It's so good to see you. Now, one thing you got to remember with cabbage is it does cut down. And after you've trimmed it, if you see any bits that are going off a little, just an off colour a little bit, just trim them off. You don't have to throw the whole cabbage out because there ain't nothing wrong with the whole cabbage. It's just them little bits of edges that are starting to turn. I've seen people throw whole cabbages out for no reason whatsoever. It's like, waste of food. The dog gets fed before we do. Norma! It's so good to see you, honey. Thank you for stopping by. Okay, that's a cabbage heart. I don't want to put a cabbage heart in it. The heart of a cabbage is wonderful. It's just like mine. Not really. It's a bit tough at times. And you cut your cabbage, just cut the cabbage in half, cut the heart out of it, and just slice it down. And kept in the right conditions, it can last quite a good length of time for you. Now we're not going to use too many of the thick stems because you don't want it to take too long, especially when somebody's jumped ahead with the chicken. Worcestershire. And then we're going to add, oh, it smells good, cooking, just that one. Fast and furious, hi, sweetie. And then we're going to add the, sometimes not helping is helping. Fireman CV! So you gave me excuses as to why you couldn't turn up. What, did you miss nothing yet? I squeezed some glutes for Grace. On the QT. Ha ha! And we're going to throw the, we're throwing the ginger in right now. Because sometimes the secret to cooking with spices is you've got to let the spice cook a little bit in order for the flavour to permeate. Thank you ever so much, Fast and Furious, for the Irish Big Hugs. I need that right now. I surely have to. Okay. I'll put a little bit in it. There it is. And if you see your oil start to smoke, you take it off. If you're using electricity, just take it straight off. Don't leave it on there and hope that it'll cool down quick enough, because it doesn't. Trust me. Now we're going to throw the cabbage in. This is Oriental cabbage, inspired by Hash Info, done my way. Now we're going to move that cabbage around so it gets coated. The ginger and Liam Perrin's Worcestershire sauce. Worcestershire. Not Worcestershire. Worcestershire. Mama, you're going to get stomped on. I'm sorry, honey. And if it starts getting too dry, you can still. Added about a teaspoon of 2 teaspoons of oil. Kerry and Mark, hi! Welcome, Yolanda! Hi, sweetie, and if I've missed anybody else coming in, I'm sorry. Okay. I'm gonna keep and toss this and throw it all over the place. Now I've got to give you a little secret. If it catches on the bottom like that, a little bit, don't freak out. Because that'll lift off and it'll taste just nice, and you'll have no problems washing your pan and getting your pan all clean. Thank you. most of the time I don't cook with measuring, I just kind of throw it in there. Caught on the bottom, just that little bit of fluid, and cooking it gently helps to bring it off, and it doesn't taste burnt. If you want, you can use soy sauce. The more colourful your meal, the better it is for you. one thing you can do with this, if you want, is you can dice the chicken up and dice the chicken and cook the chicken in with it. Mama! Hi, sweetie! So good to see you. Crystal Flames, it's wonderful to see you. Thank you all for stopping in. Well, Green Bay Wacky, bless your cotton socks, you made it. Pickrick, hey honey, thank you for coming in. Something. Lids are always your friend because it helps to stop things from drying out. Smell it? All right then, Marie, honey. Thank you for stopping in. And we shall see you again some other time. Are you coming over to Kansas Green Bay? Yep. You can come on over. Dinner will be ready for you. Trust me, I can whip something up real quick. Take you all on a ride while I open up the cupboard door. Throw your tomatoes in. That's a bit big. If you want a sauce with it and you want a slightly thicker sauce with it, you can always add a little bit of water to it, a bit more orange to it, and then you can thicken it with cornstarch. But we don't pretend need to at this point. Anything we cook, I don't use salt in it. Country Girls Adventures. Hi, sweetie, Cab 7. Hello. I think it's your anniversary today, Cab 7. Am I right? Happy anniversary. Brenda G. Hi, honey. So good to see you. The dog wants more chicken, not my husband, the dog. We've got to get out. Yeah, you can turn that off, babe. Yeah. You did? Okay, thanks. version of this. Guys, too, you know what I mean. Lee Shannon. Hey, sweetie. Sorry if I missed anybody that came in. Inspired by Hash Info, and I shall put his thing up there, and you know, right there over my left shoulder, and I shall also put a link down below and up there for the music, which is Hash Info, which is Technetic Beats. Your dish, the better it is for you. You don't need to use salt to cook with. Thank you. cooking oriental cabbage. That is just fine because dinner is now ready. You take care, Green Bay. Adriana, it was actually cooked in its own juices with garlic and herbs, and then transferred to a pan to sear it off. If that makes sense. Yeah. Two pints of soup, which actually tastes rather delicious, if I say so myself. Maniac Grammy, huge hugs, honey. Yep, and Adriana, you then call it oriental cabbage soup. And it sounds so fancy, and there's not much to it. It's quite easy to do. You know, you tell people you're making oriental cabbage or you know, an Asian inspired cabbage or an Asian cabbage. And then you tell them when you've done it and it's all you've got some left over, and then you tell them that you've made Asian cabbage soup. They're all like, wow. And that was no special cabbage. That was just regular cabbage. Ginny Bullock, honey, it's so good to see you. My style, inspired by Hash Info, and again I'll put his link, his iCard up here, right above my left shoulder, and it's also, the music is by Technetic Beats, so I should be putting his info up in the corner. I'll also be putting links down below, so if anybody ever wants to, you know, go to Technetic Beats, please do so. If you want to learn about, you know, Hash Info, please go to hashtag Hash Info. The links will be both down below and up above. So I'm going to say good night. I feel the same, and I'm gonna go enjoy my dinner. Love y'all!